After accessing the OIE website, in the left panel of the website, you will see the Compliance Assist Learning Resources. Click on this link and you will see a page of general resources that will provide help in reviewing the assessment cycle, to see what's new in the assessment process, tips for navigation, aligning with university goals, criteria we look for in annual reviews, and the links to our introductory video. Within these resources are separate links for coordinators to view instructions in PDF or in video formats for 6 types of university units. When you are ready to log into the system, select Compliance Assist Login at the bottom of the panel. This will bring you to the Mercer Secure Login page, where you will enter your Mercer University credentials, after which you will arrive at the Compliance Assist Login page. Click on the box saying Connect to Compliance Assist. On the landing site, select Planning Website. This will bring you to the home page where you may see some important announcements. Now click the Dashboard tab at the top of the page. This brings you to My Dashboard, My Roles. Click on the tab associated with your department or unit, which may read Academic Assessment Plans, Administrative Assessment Plans, etc. This will bring you to My Dashboard, My Planning Items. Make certain the academic year states the current year in which you're entering data. If not, you may need to open the Edit filter and select the correct year. Then select OK. You will then see the name of your department unit in the org chart on the left panel. Click on the name of your unit under the department or school where it is housed, and you will see the outcomes for the unit listed. Again, your unit should align with the categorical tab in which it is housed. To edit any outcome, click on the name of the outcome to open it at that particular page. Once open, you will see tabs at the top right-hand corner of this outcome page. The View tab simply shows what has been entered up to now. The Edit tab allows you to open workspaces or text boxes to write or edit. Click on Edit. You will notice instructional icon buttons at the right of most text boxes. Scrolling over these will provide you with helpful instructions as to what to enter. Each outcome is numbered and should have a short, identifiable title. The outcome description is a fuller explanation of the process, learning, or performance expected. Outcomes all have ways to measure their completion. These are called assessment methods. These are descriptions of how you expect to measure the accomplishment of the outcome. We require at least 2 methods for each outcome. Both the descriptions and methods were created earlier and should remain intact in the text boxes unless your department needs to make edits to some of these. Under each assessment method, there is a text box for Assessment Results and Analysis. Each and every assessment cycle typically reveals different assessment results. This is where you would enter those findings and any appropriate data. In the Edit mode, scroll to the first Assessment Results and Analysis text box and click Edit within the box. This allows you to enter a narrative text where you can also change fonts, bullets, and indenting using the toolbars at the top. Once completed with your entry, click Update to hold your entry in the box until you save it. To save your entries permanently, you must click Save. Proceed to the next Results and Analysis box, select Edit, and enter your narrative there. If you want to link an outcome to show how it supports university mission elements, click on the Related tab while you're in the page. This brings you to the Items page where you can add or link the outcome to other supporting outcomes. Click Add, then select Mercer University at the very top of the org chart on the left. This will reveal the goals, objectives, and visions within the Mercer Strategic Plan. Click on the box to the left of the goal or objective you determine are supported by this outcome. When finished, click Add. This will then show you the page indicating what you entered. To delete any item on the item page, simply click anywhere on the item line and click Remove Selected. When finished adding all items, click Close. This will bring you back to the dashboard.